quite poetical," commented the Scarecrow, nodding his head approvingly.
"But one day," continued the Bug, "a marvelous circumstance occurred that altered my very existence and brought me to my present pinnacle of greatness. The Professor discovered me in the act of crawling across the hearth, and before I could escape, he had caught me between his thumb and forefinger."
"My dear children," said he, "I have captured a Wogglebug, a very rare and interesting specimen. Do any of you know what a Wogglebug is?"
"No!"
yelled the scholars in chorus. "Then," said the Professor, "I will get out my famous magnifying glass and throw the insect upon a screen in a highly magnified condition, that you may all study carefully its peculiar construction and become acquainted with its habits and manner of life."
He then brought from a cupboard a most curious instrument, and before I could realize what had happened, I found myself thrown upon a screen in a highly magnified state, even as you now behold me. The students stood up on their stools and craned their heads forward to get a better view of me, and two little girls jumped upon the sill of an open window where they could see me more plainly.
"Behold," cried the Professor in a loud voice, "this highly magnified Wogglebug, one of the most curious insects in existence.